Today's video was made possible by Hulu Plus. For an extended 14-day free trial, check out huluplus.com/TOT. What's up, tech fans? Kevin here on Tech of Tomorrow. Now, a lot of you guys will remember that a couple weeks ago we put up a video where I talked about my top 5 personal favorite big-name PC games of this year. And I used that qualifier big name because I wanted to bring you guys a separate list where I talked about my top 5 favorite indie titles of 2013. Now, a lot of the same rules as last time still apply. I'm very bad at picking favorites, much less ranking them from 1st to 5th, so these are in no particular order. And I'm not trying to say that these are objectively the best or that I've played every single indie game out there, because there are a lot of them. These are just the 5 that I personally played and really enjoyed and wanted to share with you guys. So without building them up anymore, let's get right to them. Now, first off, I want to talk about a game that was in beta for a very long time and finally got fully released this year, Path of Exile. On the surface, you have a game that seems to share a lot in common with the top-down loot-grinding classic Diablo II, but then you take some RPG mechanics lifted from Final Fantasy games, like a gem system for customizing your active skills, and a gigantic passive skill tree shared by all classes, whose only difference, other than appearance, is where they start on this tree. Overall, it's a ton of hack-and-slash fun with a crazy amount of customization and character-building theory, along with a hardcore mode for players looking for a way to really test their planning and skills. If you're looking for a fun loot grinder that is also free to play, might I add, then this one's definitely worth picking up, if not at least trying for a little bit. Now, next up is a game that's trying to recapture old school difficulty with a bit of a twist, and is by far one of the most addicting games I've played this year, Rogue Legacy. Take Metroidvania-style gameplay, ramp up the difficulty, and add in a touch of randomness by having to pick new heroes every time you die, each one with a number of weird physical or mental traits, sometimes useful, sometimes negative, and sometimes just plain weird. Gameplay is fast, difficult, and there's a lot of room to grow and explore thanks to the game's skill tree and numerous randomly generated rooms, featuring a variety of challenges that can only be tackled with the right gear or the right traits. Once you start playing it, you'll find that this is one of the hardest games to put down, and even once you've beaten it, you'll have a new game plus mode that just keeps reeling you back in. Now, one of the most bizarre games I fell in love with this year is Papers, Please, a game that uses old school style graphics with one of the most bizarre overall mechanics in a game, having you work as a paper pusher at a border checkpoint. It's hard to describe how exactly this game gets as engrossing as it does, adding new mechanics and rules every day requiring a keener eye, but still doing things fast enough so you can make enough money so you don't get arrested for debt or see family die due to sickness and hunger. It's easily one of the oddest mixings of gameplay and narrative, but those that start playing it will quickly see how well it accomplishes this with its numerous endings and strangely addictive white-collar work gameplay. Fourth up, we've got a game that came out at the start of this year, a game whose visual style and trippy gameplay is matched by its excellent puzzle design, Antechamber. An excellent example of modern first-person puzzle gaming, Antechamber has by far some of the craziest and most confusing level designs, testing players' wits with puzzles that aren't just as simple as placing one item here or there, but having the very layout of areas change based on how you look at them. If you love puzzles, then this title is an absolute must-play, and those of you that are just fans of crazy visual designs might just find it to your liking as well. Now, last up is a game that is very short, but accomplishes a lot in its very short time frame and manages to punch you right in the feels, and that's Brothers. A co-op adventure game that you play with yourself, and while the controls do take a bit of getting used to at first, quickly enough you'll find yourself easily controlling two characters at once with half a controller each. Brothers manages a form of storytelling and exposition rarely seen in a game so short, and does all of it without using any kind of decipherable real-world language. Its puzzles are fun and intuitive, giving players a well-paced, strong storytelling experience that grows on you with each passing moment. Anyone that is a fan of narrative in video games must give this one a shot, and I can't stress enough how much I enjoyed this game despite its overall short length, something that normally bothers me in a lot of games today. So that was my top 5 personal favorite indie games to come out in 2013. There were a lot of great titles to come out this year, covering a large number of genres and just too many for me to choose from, and I'm sure a lot that you guys loved just didn't make the list. So make sure to let us know in the comments what ones you loved, what your favorite one is, your top 5, or even your top 10 if there's just too many to choose from. Now, before we fully wrap up, I do want to take a moment to thank Hulu Plus for helping to make this vid possible. Many of you, I'm sure, have at least watched something on Hulu, whether it's a movie or a new episode of your favorite TV show, but Hulu Plus has a lot more to offer. If you're tired of sitting at your desk but still want to stream a show or movie, then Hulu Plus will let you by streaming directly to your TV in HD using one of a number of different devices on the market. And you can even watch stuff on the go with the use of your smartphone or tablet with the Hulu Plus app. Not only that, but you'll also get access to more shows, including older seasons of your favorites, or Hulu exclusives like The Wrong Man's or Behind the Mask. Now, Hulu was awesome enough to hook us and our fans up with a special extended 14-day free trial, which you can check out by going to huluplus.com/TOT. make sure you use that link. We've got it also posted in the description, because that's going to get you those 14 days rather than the normal 7, and it lets them know that you heard about it from us. So thanks for checking out our top 5 personal favorite indie games on PC this year. Please make sure to comment to let us know your picks. There were just so many this year, almost too many to choose from. Once again, I want to thank Hulu Plus. Please make sure to check out that link in the description for the 14-day free trial. And while you're down there, if you enjoyed this vid, make sure to smash that like button to let us know. If you're not a subscriber yet, then make sure you become one, because 2014 is just around the corner. We've got a lot of great content planned for you guys in the future. You don't want to miss it. I'm Kevin for Tech of Tomorrow, and we'll see you later.